Hi Ben, good morning.
Hello.
Good morning, Ben.
Hello.
Okay, I will share to you a little spinach what we had yesterday, Ben, huh? Lagi ka ba? Hindi mo teacher Mayra. Hindi mo teacher Mayra. O, di mo madadali. Storya. Saba, asa na ba siya? Hindi po mo. Hindi mo reply mo, Sin. Hindi ko man, mo, Sin. Raba na tag-isa kasi mana. Pero si Jay, pero si Jay na ituyo. Tanawa, isin. Kunin anak ko, Chair. Nalain ang future. So nga, kita may diyang lainan. Oo, tama, mas darling. Sure. Okay, we're done with this, right?
Movie.
Yeah, we're done, right, Ben? Task six. We
Yeah.
are already in task seven. Okay, okay, Ben. So that's the end. Okay. So this is the last that we had. We are now unit 4C, listening. Okay, let's move to 4D. This is the last that we had yesterday. 4C. Okay, so Ben, we have here our topic for this morning. We have the word. Agree on definition of bilingual. In what different circumstances do people usually become bilingual? Okay, so we have here the word bilingual. Ay, spelling bilingual, bilingual, yun, spelling.
Bilingual.
Spelling mo na yun. Oy. Okay, so we have here bilingual. Okay, a person who can speak two languages equally well. Okay. And
monolingual.
Is monolingual, it means okay, one language. You can speak Ben with one language only. So another
sociolinguistics.
Sociolinguistics. Study of the way language is affected by differences in social class, religions, and
cortex.
Cortex, it's the outer layer of an organ in the body, especially the brains. Then another,
dementia.
Dementia, okay, it's a serious mental disorder caused by brain diseases or injury. It affects the ability to think, to remember and to behave normally. So that is why we have dementia.
Cerebral.
Okay, cerebral. Next, we have
Linguist. Linguist.
Linguists. It means a person who knows several foreign languages well.
Relegate.
Relegate, it's to give somebody a lower or less important position, rank than before. Relegate, to give somebody a lower or less important position. Okay, that's relegate. Okay, linguist, again, it's a person who knows several foreign languages. If you know that, you know how to speak Filipino, Vietnamese, okay, you know how to speak French. Okay, so you will be considered as linguist. Okay, another one.
Nuance.
Nuance, it's a very slight difference in meaning, sound, color, or somebody's feelings that is not usually very obvious. Okay, another is
Perception.
your perceptions. It's an idea or belief of an image or have a result of how you see or understand something.
Fringe.
Fringe, it means the outer edge of an area or a group. The outer edge of an area or a group.
Discriminate.
Discriminate, it means to recognize there is a difference between people or things, to show a difference between people or things.
Contemplate.
Contemplate, to think about whether you should do something or how you should do something. You have to contemplate. So I need to contemplate what will I do in the future. So you have to think whether what you should do or how you should do something.
Fiance.
Fiancé, it's the man that somebody is engaged to. That's your fiancé. Okay.
Extroversion.
Extroversion, it is the quality of being lively and confident. Humble, showing you do not think that you are important. That's being humble. You are humble. Okay. So here, Ben, please match the words below with the definitions.
Okay.
Yes. You can write your answer in the chat box. You tell me if you're done, Ben, ha?
Okay.
Okay. So we have here number one, to explore whether something is true. What's your answer, Ben? Okay, prove. To speculate. Conjecture. Three, very good, Ben. Three, to say that something is true without knowing for sure what is best. Ah, and to draw attention to something. Okay. Highlight. Five to one. Okay, very good. Okay, great job, Ben. Six, to cause or encourage somebody to say something. Stop. Elicit. Okay. To tell somebody off for behaving badly. Hold.
Okay.
To speak in a quick, loud, bad-tempered. It's snap. Snapping. Okay. To speak while crying with unhappiness. Snivel. To make fun of somebody in a light-hearted way. It is. And to ask somebody to do something. In threat. And to say something in a slow, rhythmical way, often as a group. Okay. Chant and to say something silently by moving your lips. That's mouth. Oh, to say something silently by moving your lips. It's mouth. We call it chant. It means to say something in a slow, rhythmical way, often as a group. You are gonna chant. Okay, but if silent, mouth. Okay. Tawa sa burong baka, oy. Okay, so please, Ben, try to read the questions 1, 3, and 4 in task 4. Okay. So, in which paragraph would you expect to find the answers? How did you work it? Okay. Read the questions 1, 3, and 4. 1, 3, and 4. In which paragraph would you expect to find the answer? Just write the number of the paragraph. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We have 7 paragraph. Okay, write only the number. Ben, ha? Wait, Ben, I will hide this one. We'll hide the hide.
Lagi? Ha? Mo sa gihikot? O siya diikot. So, parang makaiba, tagiya daso sa padong. Oh. Pero makabuhol man. Ha? Makabuhol.
Yan, pwede mo pa kakuha na dyan. Ipalking na yung kapanas kila. Yan yung bug. At tuunahan ko na itong ulit na. Ito yan.
Yang aku melakukah lagi nak kuli balik lagi aku.
Awak nak ikut dah? Okay, abu kau dalam mana tu? Awak nak ikut? Masih nak?
Ừ, sang năm mới mới giỏi hơn.
Okay, done? You cannot do it again? Huh? Oh my God. Okay, let's move to the next. Okay, so one is, look at. Okay, 01. Number two is, okay, number three is paragraph four. Okay, and here it's paragraph 5. Okay, speaking more than one language has an effect. This is in paragraph 1. Okay, look at this one. So, can learning language rewire your brain? So, as our parts of the brain expanded, resulting in more computing power of language, to what makes us hardwired for communication. What is perhaps more surprising is how language can shape our brains throughout our lives. Most of the evidence for this comes from studies of people who are bilingual. Okay, bilingual, speaking more than one language has an effect on. So this is what it means with number one, paragraph one. So in paragraph, in number three, the theory that people cannot understand a concept if their language has no word for it. This is in paragraph four. Okay. In paragraph four, it is said the idea the language you speak could influence how think dates back to 1940, when linguist Benjamin Lee were proposed that people whose languages lack words for concept would not understand it. And it was relegated to French science until early 2000, when a few people began proving a related but more nuisance idea that language can influence perceptions. Greek, for instance, has two words for blue, like balazio for light blue and blue for darker shade. Okay, so a study found that Greek speaker could discriminate shades of blue faster and better than native English speaker. Okay, so number three, it is said the theory that people cannot understand the concept if their language has no word for it. This is what it means for number four. I know, Ben, you really find hard because some of the words here is quite hard, deep. Okay? So number four, it's in number five. So number four questions, it's in paragraph five. Studies suggest that speaker of different languages. Studies suggest that speaker of different languages, there is no answer, that. Okay. Language events is epic or sense space and time. For example, an aboriginal tribe in the South and North Australia doesn't have words for it. Like left, right, but does not have terms for north, south, east, and west. Okay. So it is here. More generally, language help us understand the world by allowing us to categorize things. Okay, it should be categorized things. Studies suggest that speakers of different language. It is really hard, number four, Ben, because it's hanging. The question is hanging. Studies suggest that speakers of different languages. No, sumpay. Okay, can you say that one? It's hanging. Okay, let us move this one. I know you find it really hard. Okay, let us skip this one. Okay, this one. You find it hard? Okay, this one. Speaking more than language has the part of brain where language is processed, the part of brain which make decisive. Okay. Oh, that one, Ben, you try. You just in circle. Anyway, there's a question with this one. I will hide again the panel. Opo, kasamok ba nandang baka eh? Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Smoke.
Okay.
Okay. Speaking more than one language. Okay. Letter B. Okay. Studies described in paragraph 2 suggest that. Okay. Letter C. Okay. The theory that people cannot understand concept if their language has no word for it. Okay, letter B. Okay, very good, Ben. Okay, next one, number 4. Okay, just read properly, okay? Okay. So studies suggest that speakers of different languages Okay. May think about time in different ways. Okay. Describe their own personality differently. A. Describe their own personality. Okay. What is the main point of the text as a whole? It is letter A. Okay. Next one, B. A, Ben. Okay. Find example of direct speech. Okay. Do you know this? Okay, so let us skip this one, Ben. Okay, so this one. You have discussed the quote below from the text. What do you think it means? Do you agree? Why and why not? Okay, so this is the quote. Okay, to have another language is to possess a second soul. The example, you are a linguist. You know how to speak. Or languages. So, it is said to have another language is to possess a second soul. It is true. Do you agree or you don't agree? Then why or why not? Okay. You can write your answer, Ben, in the chat box. Okay. It doesn't mean you have to make it too long. As long as you get the point, you answer it, and you have to defend your answer why or why not. Okay? Oh, you have so many pimples, Ben. What happened to your face? Oh, like that one. You have pimples. Maybe you sleep late. Okay, go na. What is your sabon, Ben? Your soap. What soap did you use?
What?
What soap did you use? Katawar, wait, turn. This one.
What do you mean? What do you mean?
Okay, I write.
I don't know.
Okay, do you set up pill? This one.
I use soap in my face. I don't know. No, it's different.
Okay. So maybe please don't try to wake up late. I mean to sleep late.
Okay.
Yes. Okay.
Okay.
Let me see your answer. Where's your answer? Okay, it means that if you have another languages, you have new personality. Oh, so I agree because if I have another language, I will feel very confident. Okay, very good, Ben.
Okay.
Yes. Okay, that's good. Wow, great job. Okay, so Ben, okay, so we have... Okay, so Ben, we are, what time is it there in your country?
Almost 9 a.m.
9 a.m. Okay, that's good. Okay, so I will see you, Ben. By the way, Ben, Friday. Okay, do we have makeup class, more makeup class?
Why?
No, I am asking because when teacher N was absent, I was not having a makeup class. We have one now, so we need another one. Would that be okay for you this week or next week with the one makeup class?
I'll ask my mom.
You tell your mom you have one makeup class more. Okay, would that be this week or next week, huh? But I will see you on Saturday and Sunday again. Okay, Ben?
Okay.
Okay, thank you, Ben. You tell me, Ben, how would it be next week? Or this week, we will use the one more makeup class. Okay?
Okay.
Okay, thank you, Ben. See you, Ben.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.